LaPenta. This is WICR.
All right. Hello, Iona College. You're back here with Lights Out Sports. Now, guys, we're going to talk some MVP race in the NBA. Guys, top three right now, LeBron James, James Harden, and Steph Curry. Who do you guys think is the MVP at this point in the season?
Chef cooking with the pot, boy. I'm being serious. Stephen Curry's my MVP. I'm not going to lie. Stephen Curry's really my MVP. He always plays so efficient every night. I'm going with Stephen Curry. I'm being so serious.
Yeah, you know. Nah, the dude's killing your voice. Nah, I honestly agree with the chef over there. He's been cooking with the pot real well. Recently they've been struggling, the Warriors, but they have the best record in the league besides the Hawks in the West. And, you know, Curry, he put this team back on the map. He really did. That's what you have to give him the credit. And, I mean, they've been building up last year. They, you know, they try to make some noise in the playoffs. And every year they've just been improving. Stephen Curry's been improving. He's become an all-around point guard. He plays defense. He's a playmaker. I mean, this guy is the MVP.
Like, there's nothing wrong with James Harden and LeBron, though. Harden gets most of his points from the line, like you said before, which is true. LeBron, all those weapons.
I don't think LeBron deserves it.
Yeah, no, I think.
Because.
He deserves to be, you know, in the talk and in the race and everything. But, like, you know, when you're on a team with Kyrie and Kevin Love and J.R. Smith, you got to, like, just look back and look at Stephen Curry. How it's just, like, it's him, basically, and Klay Thompson. And you're right, Klay Thompson has
yeah, but the Cavaliers, they have, yes, they've been great. They've won, what did they win, like, 19 of the last 21 games or something like that?
Stephen Curry's been,
put that team that great. LeBron wasn't playing that good in the beginning of the season.
Exactly. Like, they was having
LeBron's
some struggles.
Been playing great over the last 2 months.
They've been having some struggles.
In order to
Cavaliers.
Be the MVP, I feel like from start to finish, you've been that consistently superior player.
You're right. And that's why I'm going with and that's why I'm going with Stephen Curry.
I would go with Curry, and then, I mean, I guess.
Second, I put
Harden. I would play probably Harden. So actually, you know what I'm going to say?
Russell Westbrook?
I do. I think it's Russell Westbrook. Russell Westbrook has had, like, his.
Tremendous.
His last 2 months have not even been heard of. The amount of triple doubles, the points, everything.
Exactly. Like, he had back
this
to back.
This team was out of the playoff games. Picture, and now they're like 9 games over. They were under by like 8 games at one point.
The only problem is this is gonna be the biggest problem. Russell Westbrook missed a decent amount of games.
That's a very good issue.
Up to this point, though, he's been a triple double machine.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
He's carrying the load. He has to. You know what? A lot of people are gonna condemn. Oh, he's taking a lot of shots. He has to. Durant's out with that foot injury.
Exactly. The same thing happened last year. Durant did the same thing, and he won the MVP. Russell Westbrook went down.
That's what I love about Russell Westbrook, too. Like, Russell? I think because Russell Westbrook.
He said Russell.
I think because of that injury, you know, he's come back stronger. It's like most players do. You know, I'm going to come back stronger, and that's what he did.
Clearly, Derrick Rose didn't do that.
You're right, though. Clearly, Derrick Rose
didn't do that. I'm going to be honest with you. His name is not on there, but it should be. Rob said his name before, DeAndre Jordan. Why not? Why not? Joakim Noah was up there last year his 10 points, 11 rebounds, and 5 assists. Why can't DeAndre Jordan be up there?
You know
there?
Who should replace?
And the thing is, nobody looks at DeAndre Jordan.
No.
And it's aggravating because even All-Star Weekend.
He's better than Dwight Howard ever was. Ever was. He plays the same exact game that Dwight Howard played, but he plays stronger, faster, and more aggressive.
And even the All-Star team. Why was he not looked at? Doctors argue that. Why was he not looked at?
There was
he's
a lot
a
of
great ball
there's a lot of players in the West too. You gotta think about.
There's a lot of players in the West. DeAndre Jordan is phenomenal.
Plays the same exact game as Dwight Howard.
I know, but there was
Howard doesn't have a post game. DeAndre Jordan does, and DeAndre Jordan does everything better than Dwight Howard does.
But
everything.
All star. There were so many snubs though. DeMarcus Cousins
was
snubbed.
Dwight Howard might be a better.
Damian Lillard was snubbed. There was a lot of snubs for that. I'm not gonna lie. Zach Randolph was snubbed. Why couldn't
Zach Randolph should definitely
hate it. There was a lot of snubs for that West. So I see why he was overlooked though. But DeAndre Jordan has been playing great though. Like they have Kyle Lowry.
Rob, scroll down. What other names you got on there?
They have Kyle Lowry in that MVP list though. Kyle Lowry, he's foul.
I have Jeff Teague, LaMarcus Aldridge, Klay Thompson. LaMarcus, you're gonna look at
LaMarcus deserves
he's
it.
He's playing through an injury.
Yeah, he's
LaMarcus
playing through a
thumb
broken
injury. LaMarcus
thumb.
Has been playing
and
great.
He's
too.
Been playing great up to this point. Klay Thompson's falling off the map.
No,
Klay
Thompson, no.
He's dropping in numbers.
He's been horrible.
Marcus Saul, could give him the case, though.
But Mark and Zach, though, they both together.
They're both the MVP. They're not MVP. One of them doesn't outshine the other.
Exactly. They both play so
you can't pick
together.
One over the other.
Mm-hmm. I mean, the guy I really like right now for MVP is James Harden. And it's just because I've been looking at, he's doing basically everything without Dwight Howard. Yes, you guys are going to throw the argument to me. Yes, he scores all his points at the free throw line. But over the last couple weeks, have you not seen how he really has changed his game IQ? I've really seen his eyes open up, that presence where he knows more where guys are on the court. Guys are wide open, scoring
Harden
points.
Harden doesn't play any defense, so that really, yeah, that's really, really annoys me.
Stephen Curry, it's horrible. At least he tries.
Curry's a pretty good. He's not that
really
bad.
He's a good rebound. Defender.
And like Curry does everything to win the game. I just don't like. And Harden last night, he kicked LeBron.
He lacks defense.
Clearly, there was some intent behind that.
Come on. Like with Stephen Curry, though, he doesn't lose his temper as much.
Curry brings professionalism.
Curry is a professional balanced player. Always have had respect for him, even dating back to his Davidson days, where everybody said going into the draft, oh, he's never going to be anything. He's never going to be anything. And you know what? He proved everybody wrong.
Curry has to work so much harder, being his height and how small he is, his weight.
And
he's not
so
even
great,
that
though.
Athletic. Like, talking body-wise, not skill-wise.
He's not like a Westbrook or Derrick Rose explosive.
He's almost got a body like you, Terrence, but just a little heavier.
He's skinny.
He's really skinny and slender.
He's not as explosive as like a Westbrook or Derrick Rose, but he could
take
it to the
lane. He gets
the
job done. He could do the same exact thing, but not over the rim.
Exactly. He could take it to the hole,
Curry deserves this MVP. He really, really does. If LeBron wins, I'm going to be really upset.
LeBron's not going to win.
I feel like LeBron's going to win because LeBron, I know he's your favorite player, but LeBron and the media loves LeBron.
I know, but to me, personally, I even said
the league, the media, everybody loves LeBron. Everybody wants LeBron to be the best.
But you know what they're actually talking about? There was actually an article that said that Stephen Curry, well, they put him ahead of LeBron. Is he the new talk of the town now? I'm like, he's up there, though.
Best player in the league? You're talking about, like,
no, they're not
talking
MVP,
you're talking
about. But they were just talking about, like, you know, like, name-wise, like, you know, is he going to be ahead of LeBron? You know, that person, like, you see LeBron in all these Kia commercials, Sprite commercials. Is Stephen Curry going to be that new guy? I think eventually he will be that new guy, though. To see him all, his face is going to be plastered all over the
wall.
I'll
be honest with you, LeBron's on the way out, though, because you're talking his, what is he, 30?
Yeah, she's 30 years old.
LeBron's probably got four or five more years of...
Seven.
37. Kobe's getting it done, but Kobe tries harder than anyone else in the league. LeBron, recently, his injuries have inclined.
But LeBron, I think he'll change his game, though. He'll change his game. He knows that,
but
too.
But he's not
like,
that great of a shooter to change his game.
He's gonna have to, though.
You know what it comes down to, though? You know, me and my uncle were discussing this. We look back in the 90s, guys, right? Players could play to late 37, maybe 38 years old, some NBA players. Now it's like everybody's into that whole weightlifting, all that putting all that work into your body. How many minutes did LeBron play back in Miami? LeBron was logging in 40 minutes in the playoffs or more. Your body can't take that toll. Back in the day, you know, we discussed players weren't doing that much damage to the body. Now with all this weightlifting, you're doing a lot of damage to your body. And players like LeBron, we're going to see in the next couple years, it's going to be a decline in age where it's going to be maybe 34, 33 years old where your body is done at that point.
You're right, because
what happened to Tracy, it's what happened to Vince. All these athletic players who rely on using their athleticism and their physicality.
Like, I'm like, you have to, like, look at Jordan. He wasn't the biggest player. Like, he wasn't like a LeBron. Like, he's like a slender build. And he relied on his skills and technique to do the work for him.
I think if LeBron, like, if he starts to lose his muscle mass and everything, LeBron James is going
to
shrug because LeBron is not as gifted as a scorer as these other best players. LeBron uses his body.
LeBron's built like a football player.
Exactly. And he drives the lane and people are afraid to get by him because he's just going to shield you off. That's what makes him so good. At 34, you're not going to move like that.
You've seen LeBron make that a layup over Terrence Jones and who was that?
But you think LeBron could expand his game and become a jump shooter? Consistently,
he's trying. Like, you see him trying, though.
I think he's trying, but still, I don't think he's that.
But I don't think it's gonna be.
He don't scare me when he shoots the ball.
I don't think it's gonna be like a.
He just drives.
I think it's a bailout when he drives. I'm like, oh, that's a bad man.
I don't think it's gonna be like a, you know, like a Dwayne Wade, and you see Dwayne Wade's injuries are just killing him right now.
Dwayne Wade can't even shoot from the outside.
He used to be able to, though. Like Dwayne Wade has
his
mid range though. Like, but he's not a great 3-point shooter though. Nah. I don't think LeBron is gonna decline. But you see Wade is clearly declining right now though. But eventually,
LeBron's going
to
need to work on his shot, or he's not going
to
be breaking all these records.
Yeah, it's...
Because...
I mean, can we almost argue the same for Durant, too? Durant's not big either, but...
Well, no, the problem is when Durant falls off, he can still be an effective player, because he can shoot the basketball real well. You know what I mean?
Yeah, LeBron... And Durant's not that body type like LeBron. Yeah, I have to understand, like, with the whole weightlifting perspective, because I've started, like, looking into when I even work out, your joints, all your joint muscles, you're using all these muscles, and the weights, we were never really men supposed to lift like that, really. Body is supposed to just be all natural, like push-ups, sit-ups, not weightlifting. Weightlifting actually harms your body towards the end, you know. You'll see, like, your 20s, you're 20, you could do anything. Like, people I see at the gym could do 800 to 900 pounds. No, not 800 or 900. What am I talking about?
What, are you talking about Hercules? What kind of gym you go to? You go to Mount Olympus?
No, you can see maybe like...
Zeus.
You can see...
Some
you can see maybe like 300, 400 pounds.
800, 900. Oh, my God.
Robert.
Yo, I'm just thinking about Dwayne The Rock Johnson. Come on.
No, you're just thinking about some fantasy land.
You think I'm steroids.
No, not even steroids. Some great steroids.
But
not
right,
even A-Rod would lift that with steroids.
Exactly, but you're right, though, with all this weightlifting. Though,
yes,
that's really
the
not,
calculations
that's not
weren't correct, but yes, the idea was correct.
that's damage to your body, and you'll see later on, you hit that point in your life.
That's
where
why
you
people
hit your
say 30s. You should always do like calisthenics and all that.
Because even in the 40s, I've heard, like, my uncle, he's 35 years old.
That's all I do.
He sees it now.
I just do, like push-ups and sit-ups and all that.
And look
that.
At Tim Duncan, though. He's old, too, but he's still getting the job done for his team, though.
Yeah,
and he's not the and you rarely see decline. He made it to the All-Star again. He's really like he's,
well,
he's
I feel
really
like
declining.
When it comes to a big man could play into
big
his
men
40s.
Tend to get more injured though, but they tend to get more injured
I
too
feel
though.
Like when you're a guard, is more running, you're bringing the ball up, you're doing more on.
You're right though. Yeah,
you're a bigger presence on the team, and like that's why with Vince and everything. Vince is 38. I mean, Kobe's.
And look,
what's
and
Kobe?
Like, and you're right, like LeBron,
Kobe's
he's playing almost
35, 36 years
and
old.
Both Vince and Kobe are coming off pretty severe injuries.
Yeah.
But Kobe, he's going to make a return, though.
Kobe, especially over the last couple of years.
You
want to
know why Kobe
return,
got
though.
Injured, though? Why Kobe got injured?
Because of those low Kobe sneakers.
No, because...
I think that's a reason, too.
No, I think because Kobe thinks that he's still a kid, that he could play over 30 minutes. Byron Scott doesn't monitor that because Kobe tells him, oh, I'm doing
this. He plays high in the 30s, too. He only play, like, at 30. He played, like, what, 36?
What does Duncan play? Duncan doesn't play
30
minutes.
No, he's on a minutes conservative, yeah.
Well,
yeah.
Pop is smart, and he knows how to, like, conserve Tim
Kobe's
Duncan.
Kobe's at that point where he has to be conserved. It's not, Kobe, you're not 25 years old.
Vince plays,
Kobe,
Vince plays 24 minutes, 20.
Kobe's too, like, how you
Kobe's
say
too...
I'm not going to say cocky,
I wasn't
saying
arrogant.
Not really arrogant or cocky, but...
Too into himself.
Exactly.
His ego is way too big.
Exactly. Like he thinks
he'll never give up.
He thinks he could still do what he did back in the days. And he can still do, that fadeaway pull-up.
You know why?
Because
no player in the NBA has ever had a killer instinct like Kobe Bryant. Kobe Bryant tries harder than any other NBA basketball player.
Exactly. And I'm not
Jordan at Kobe's age was not Jordan-like. No one at Kobe's age was able to put the number... Like, Kobe, he's putting so much workload and effort on his whole... body and mentality, like, it's killing him.
And, we're not the biggest Kobe fans, but it's actually going to be, like, kind of sad when Kobe retires, though, because you're never going to see a great scorer like that,
No,
too. That's going to be kind of sad.
Ever.
Like, and he was exciting to watch, too. Like, when you see him get the ball, and he's, like, he's posted up, like, it's just exciting.
That's why
you're
I
like,
say
what is
Kobe's the deadliest scorer of all time.
He is. He's, like, it's
all
gonna,
he ever thinks about.
That's
like,
why I said it's going to be sad when he retires. He's so, like, his killer instinct, his motivation
to
win.
Yeah, he's had a lot of off, with the whole girl... The whole rape issue and what else? With him and Shaq, the fighting. I mean, Kobe's had his problems.
Karl Malone, Gary Payton.
Yeah, he's had his problems and everything. But Kobe Bryant has been
a
great, great role model for little kids.
He's
going
to be remembered as, up there with Jordan, too.
And you guys remember when the free agent market hit? He almost signed with the Los Angeles Clippers.
I thought it was the Pistons.
No,
he said he wanted to go to the Bulls. I read somewhere he wanted to go to the Bulls in 07.
The Clippers it came down to. But they talked him in. We're going to get this back together. We will get you champions.
Exactly.
How would he go to the
Kobe
Clippers?
Kobe bleeds gold and purple.
Who was even on the Clippers in 07? Elton Brand?
You had Elton Brand, Chris Kaman, Catino Mobley.
But Catino Mobley was on the way out then.
Still around.
McGetty was all right.
Corey McGetty.
You might have, I think even Sam Cassell was around and Baron Davis maybe at that time.
No, Baron it wasn't Davis. Baron. No, Baron Davis on the Warriors because that was when they beat the Mavericks.
Yes.
The Maverick team that went, 67-15 or something like that? 68-14?
But still, regardless, you knew Kobe wasn't going to leave, though. He bleeds purple and gold. That's his team right there. He even said it, too. He's a diehard Laker fan. He said he's not going nowhere.
Yeah, but you know what I don't like about Kobe? If Kobe is so into winning and everything, he should have did what Dirk did last year. Dirk Nowitzki took a major pay cut. Dirk Nowitzki was making $20 million a year. He's only making, 7.90 million a year now over the next 3 years. Mm-hmm. Kobe Bryant got signed to a 2-year, $50 million extension.
$25 million.
Like, if Kobe could have used that $50 million, he could have took, all right, let me sign for a 2-year, $20 million extension.
I don't see why he would do that, too.
You have all $30 caps, $30 million cap space?
And on top of that, Kobe has all these endorsements with Nike, and it's like, why would you? You're getting money regardless, though. He's getting a lot of money.
But they could have went at players like Kevin Love and all these other big free agents this summer.
Chris Paul.
Yeah,
no, that well, Chris Paul. But that was actually
just that Chris Paul should have been a Laker.
That was when David Stern he actually vetoed
that. That was ridiculous how trade, Chris Bosh and LeBron James can become a Miami Heat, but Chris Paul couldn't go to the Lakers. That was horrible.
That was David Stern that did that.
No, that
David Stern owned the league, owned the team at that point. That was the problem.
Yeah, the New Orleans, right?
Yeah, and that you look at it, they probably could have worked out well together. And even if you bring in Pau Gasol to that team, definitely would have worked out very well for this team. I mean, with the Lakers, though, we go back to you, Armand, with your comment about Dirk Nowitzki. Yes, you take that pay cut. At this point, Kobe should have taken the pay cut. Not even $10 million.
Dirk cares about the team and winning. I feel like Kobe says it, but I feel like he doesn't. Not anymore. I don't know.
Yeah, he doesn't. Not even at this point. If Kobe was a realistic player, not even $10 million. I'm sorry. Not even $10 million. I'm not throwing $10 million at Kobe Bryant. I would have let him walk out the door. I'm sorry. That's just me. At this point in his career.
The only thing I could think of is the difference between Kobe and Dirk. Dirk Nowitzki's only won one NBA Finals. I feel like Kobe, this is where the arrogance comes into play. Kobe's been there. He's won how many? Five?
Five.
So, like, care if he wins another. I mean, he would like to tie Jordan.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that keeps him up.
But obviously, he doesn't care. You know why he's trying? He has that old man mentality now. He's trying to take all the money he can and run with it.
Oh, like Steve Nash.
I think
Steve Nash should just retire.
Dirk Nowitzki's thinking a whole nother logic. He's like, I got plenty of money to go around. Let me try and bring in players like Parsons and Chandler and all the guys they've brought in.
Too. Kobe, like, look at his team now. It's like, who's your best player? Ed Davis?
Jeremy Lin and Boozer.
Wesley Johnson. Role players too. Almost as bad as the Knicks. Almost as bad. Not as bad, almost.
They're ridiculous to watch. They're just like the Knicks. They're ridiculous to watch.
No, they're not.
The Lakers at a point are ridiculous to watch.
They're only
three games better than the Knicks.
If your point guard can't average over 7 to 8 assists a game, you got problems. Jeremy Lin is a god-awful point guard.
Well,
not that many point guards
average over 7 or 8 assists, though, Rob.
He doesn't even get
like maybe half
though,
of them.
Jeremy Lin.
No, Jeremy Lin's horrible.
We're looking at from,
absolutely.
I mean, it's amazing how Jeremy Lin goes from New York to Los Angeles, though. That's just,
yeah,
he
why
goes
is he
these
going
big
to these big market teams?
It's just crazy. Just
you know why? Because Jeremy Lin brings the whole insanity endorsement, the first Asian player, besides Yao Ming.
Jeremy Lin was brought to the Lakers as just a cap drop because his contract's
from expire. The Rockets. Yeah, he's going to expire. That's true. We forgot about that.
And the Lakers traded nothing for him, so they really have nothing to worry about. I mean, we just talked about the MVP race. Let's just keep rolling. Let's talk about right now NBA playoffs right now. What do you guys think right now? We currently looking at the Eastern and Western conferences. What team is the team to really watch out for?
I say Cleveland when Kyrie Irving comes back. I mean, you see he's injured, though, but I say Cleveland right now, though.
Oh, I got a news update, guys, from the NBA. Nuggets fire coach Brian Shaw. Multiple reports. 56-85 record with the team, including a 20-39 this season. Your thoughts on Brian Shaw and the Denver Nuggets?
Okay, it's about time. Let's just go with that.
It's about time. The guy knew nothing about coaching.
Exactly.
The guy, they're like, oh, he's the best assistant coach in the NBA right now.
Look at Timmy Trumaz guy. Look how great he's doing with Cleveland. He's doing tremendous.
Well, honestly, I thought Rob even said this too. I remember Rob saying Ty Lawson should have been on the move. They should have got rid of Kenan Faried because Kenan Faried, the whole experiment, the manimal. It's not working. The guy has a lot of talent.
He did
something's
so great
not working.
You
know what the problem is? Even Gallinari. Gallinari came to Denver and dropped everyone.
The problem was when you fired Coach of the Year Karl Malone. That's where you all went wrong. You know what? I don't care that he never got out of the first round of the playoffs. He got the Nuggets there every single year. You can't put all the blame on him.
No, they got out of the first round.
Yeah, they did.
When they played the Lakers in the Western Finals. But I mean, it wasn't a really good series.
I mean, we all knew that Denver would have won that, but, like, you knew that was going to probably lose, you know, round two, though.
But I'm happy Shaw's gone because he was highlighted as, like, the greatest assistant coach. I didn't even see that with Popovich's guys with the Spurs, where they were highlighted, oh, he's going to be excellent.
Well, Budenholzer, I mean, you thought this guy was going to have a good career. Mm-hmm. That guy can coach.
But we look now, Brian Shaw, they're like, oh, with the Lakers, oh, he knows everything. He knows legit everything. He knew nothing.
I was never a big fan. I mean, I wasn't a really big fan on the Nuggets, you know, prosperity and success this year. I was not on board with that. I didn't think they were going to do good at all. I think their record shows what they are.
The question is now, who picks them up as an assistant coach?
No, the question is, who are the Nuggets going to have as a head coach next season?
The question is, where are all these players going? Where's Ty Lawson going? Where's Faried going?
The question is, the Denver Nuggets should relocate.
Maybe that too. Maybe they should just, you know, get rid of everybody and just, you know.
Now, like, might be the whole climate out there, you know. It's,
maybe it's time to rebuild.
I'm going to throw a name out there right now because there was rumors that he was going to take the Kings job earlier this year, but he wanted...
Don't say Shaquille O'Neal.
No, not Shaquille O'Neal. It goes back to he wanted to coach during the summer to have his team prepared. Chris Mullin wants to go into coaching.
What's wrong with that? Chris Mullin, I think Chris Mullin would be a good coach. The guy knew how to win in the NBA.
Because tell me right now, who's out there that you would pick as your head coach? Mike D'Antoni, definitely not. Not even close. Yeah, you're going to average 100 points, but you're going to give up 120 points.
I was never a big fan of Mike D'Antoni.
I mean, who? Not really anybody's out there right now.
Mike Woodson.
Lenny Wilkins. No.
Mike Woodson.
Mike Woodson.
Lawrence Frank.
PJ Carlissimo.
Obviously, we have nobody. Which
nah, there really isn't anybody.
There really isn't anybody. Like.
I think Mark Jackson should come back.
Yeah, you know what? Honestly,
he was a good coach. If anyone should be credited for this whole Warriors success, it's Mark Jackson. Mark Jackson, basically, Steve Kerr is getting all the credit for Mark Jackson's moves from last year. These are all as a result of the Mark Jackson, like, you know, season.
But Steve Kerr is doing something with that Golden State team because
I know, but
they
Mark Jackson
one,
set
though.
This whole thing in motion.
He did, you know, all those players.
That's like a president, you know, his policies are good and everything, and the next president comes in and, you know, the whole, everything goes up, you know, the economy is boosting. It's because of the first president. That's what I'm looking at with Steve Kerr. He's coming in next season with all these players who are excelling because of what Stephen Curry's probably became such a great point guard because of Mark Jackson.
Yeah.
I think so, too. He helped him out with his... They always had shoot-arounds, too.
Mark Jackson's been there, done that. He was a good point guard, one of the best passers in the league during his time.
He was only fired because ownership didn't like him. That was the only reason why he was fired.
That was a bunch of BS, but it's whatever.
I mean, that would be a great pickup, yeah. I think. Because you know what? It's not like they're a bunch of old guys on that team. They're still young, maybe around 26, 27, 28
exactly.
years old range. They're still young. Mark could probably rejuvenate this team. Definitely would be a great pickup.
I think Mark Jackson's a great guy. He can help Ty Lawson, too. Ty Lawson's a great point guard.
What if, like, can
never
Mark Jackson
talked
help
about.
Out Ty Lawson like he did with Stephen Curry?
Yeah,
that's our coach. Let's hope we see it done.
Mark was great with the Knicks, great with the Pacers. Great point guard overall. Really smart guy. And really hope, you know what? I actually really do hope he ends up now with Denver. I really could see him fitting in well. He has the big guys he needs over there. He got Kenneth Faried. He had David Lee and Bogut.
I don't think Kenneth Faried's going to be there in the summer.
Nah.
Either one or the other, Ty Lawson or Kenneth Faried. They've been there way too long. The Nuggets have been in a drought for way too long since Melo's left.
Even
so.
Gallinari, he's fine.
They all have a nice salary too.
And you just look
they're paid pretty well.
But look at Kenneth
Faried like
as a big small forward because he's 6'9" and he's playing the power forward. Has no post game. Can't shoot.
Well, he gets the job. I mean, he can rebound pretty well. That's why right, he's like Draymond Green plays the same, but Draymond Green can
Draymond
shoot
Green
somewhat.
But this season though, Kenneth Faried has not
no,
been doing
it's
so
just
great,
the Nuggets
though.
In general. Brian Shaw's the reason he should have
fired. And Ty Lawson, he's declined in almost everything, and that's terrible.
Yeah.
There are games I watch where Wilson Chandler's taking the most shots for them.
Games where Randy Ford takes a lot of shots.
Yeah, Mr. Quadruple Double.
Mr. Quadruple
2K.
Double, Randy Ford.
Just another reason why I can't base anything off 2K. Robert.
Except for Iguodala, right?
Don't go there
no,
with
no,
Sean.
No. Wait,
Sean Edwards, he's on a show at what time? 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock later?
Yeah,
o'clock.
I'm pretty sure
anything
he talks about
Sean
Iguodala.
Says is not credible because Sean says Andre Iguodala had all the tools to be a future Hall of Famer and a superstar
in the
NBA.
He said he could be a LeBron James.
He said he's a poor man's LeBron or something. What did he say?
He basically said he's a poor man's LeBron. I'm like, okay.
That's ridiculous.
First off, you got to make it to the All-Star. He made it once in Philadelphia.
The best season he had was 19 a game. Come on. Come on, Sean Edwards.
You know what was funny? We was looking up stats. You know who had more points than him in the game? Courtney Lee had more points in the game.
We went through the whole
list.
Actually,
2K? 2K's
we
actually,
found
actually,
that.
2K actually has a lot of stats, though. They should have Courtney
they
Lee
should.
Had more
they
points.
Had their whole career, you know,
Jeff
profile.
Green had more points. Mario Chalmers was close, though.
You know who was next to him? I'm pretty sure Luke Walton.
I also think, you know, the White Mamba himself was up there, too.
Oh, Scal?
Yeah, I think he was there.
Nah, he was. I think his career hour was like 15, bro.
So we're not going to talk about Iguodala, though.
No, we don't want that.
You're going to lay off for him.
No.
All right. So that's pretty much all what we have for today for you guys. I'm Rob Boncardo.
I'm Armand Mateo.
I'm Terrence Taylor.
And turn in next Tuesday at 12 o'clock. We're Lights Out Sports. Have a good day, everyone.
You're listening to WIC.